Monsoon here. I don't know capturing any. This is a driving torrential downpour. I probably shouldn't be filming this. Just trying to drive safely to work, but visibility is not well. Not well. Not well. I ain't seeing much out there. No, I am alright. It's Monday. June the 10th, it's 9 a.m. on the dot, hit the tone, 9 a.m. on a Monday, 2013, the 10th day of June. Well, the weather report, I don't have to tell you much about what's going on right now. It got really nice yesterday, Sunday afternoon, evening, and I had a really nice weekend. The last time you left me, I was hoping I would, and I did. My foot hurt, my foot issues are still continue to be a problem, although this morning they're a tick better than yesterday, but that's really relative to the fact that they turned a lot worse when back over the weekend again. So they got worse, and now they're slightly better again. So I'm still dealing with that. I'm probably going to go see a doctor. Maybe I'll record that audio for a bonus episode of Lifecast, which is available on lifecast.info. First of all, we got a lot of big things on the horizon for me. I got a book coming out later today. I'm going to finish testing it on our website. All the pieces are done. I tested a print job of the book. It looks good. I made it myself. It's a hand-stitched little tiny book. It fits in your back pocket. It's in the back pocket of a very tiny human-like person as well, because it's very small. It's 16 short stories. They're micro-fiction, I guess you could call them, flash fiction, but they're a little bit, they're not just, I took some time with these, I did edit them, and they're cut down from a batch of 40 ideas. So I tried to hone in on these. And it's much more than just a set of 16 little stories. It's got videos, songs, and words, and animated GIFs. And that's available at aaa.info. That's just 12 A's, so count out in your head, 12 A's.info. Enough about that, though. I've moved on. I'll finish that, and then we can move on. Hopefully this morning, that'll be live. And ready to go, ready to roll. I have a lot of video I took. I was basically home all weekend, so when I'm doing these other projects like Lifecast.info, which is another project I do, I wonder how boring that is, because I didn't really leave the house this weekend. I just worked on projects, worked on some stuff, and got caught up on some projects. My daily EP project, that's at dailyep.bandcamp.com. dailyep.bandcamp.com. What else? 9:03 a.m. We're moving towards an uncertain future. This is really something I'm hearing. So if you're in a good space, and listen, I haven't drank for what'll be going on over 3 weeks. This will be week number 4 without really consuming any alcohol, and it's amazing. And I touched on this a little, but let me expand on what it's done to my ability to dream and have dreams at night. I swear to you, if you're a somewhat heavy drinker, and by that I mean you get drunk typically once or twice a week. If not more, but I've been at that range. I had stopped dreaming. I swear to God, I was dreaming like once a month, once every 2 months. I think tops. That's a pretty fair estimate as far, it's probably less than that. might have even been, I can't remember. But I've been dreaming almost every night now that I'm three weeks removed from not having any alcohol in my system. And I think that has to be connected to what alcohol does long-term, like, you know, what do they call that? Longitudinal, something like that. The effect that it has on your brain. And I want to write about this and put it on my blog at marinaml.com, but I will just relay a quick dream I had last night where Kristen Stewart, who I'm very fond of, you know, she's definitely my type. I had a dream where I was dating her. And it was hilarious because, like, we were just, like, in a relationship. And your brain is just funny because it does, your brain does funny things. That's insane. What is this guy doing? Let me interrupt for 1 second. You see this man? He's got a leaf blower out. He's doing something with the water. I can't imagine that's doing anything at all. Oh, what? I don't even know what he's doing. Anyway, this Kristen Stewart dream, my ability to remember dreams has always been kind of flaky, but I do remember, like, bits and pieces and certain, like, ideas, and, like, sometimes I'll fade in out of one. I won't remember, like, a middle part of a dream. We're in a hotel room. I'm hungry. She's like, yeah, my mom, well, we were with my parents, and she's like, ask your mom if we can go watch a movie in my mom's room. She was just next door, but somehow the two moms weren't talking, my mom and Kristen Stewart's mom. So we go in there and I'm hungry and I'm like, do you guys have any food? And I'm like, yeah, it's in the fridge in the closet. I was like, okay, we're in a hotel. I'm sure there's a salad or coleslaw. So I'm looking for this fridge. I'm like, I can't find it. And she's like, it's in the back row. And I find these little, like, compartments, like, you know, at, like, Subway where they keep, like, the onions and the tomatoes, like, little dishes like that. They didn't look refrigerated, but there's, like, six slots. And each one of them had, like, a different version of coleslaw in them. And she's like, here, just hit a plate. And I was like, just use your hands. So I had to scoop out coleslaw from Kristen Stewart's mom's hotel room, closet, Subway container case, and put coleslaw on a plate that I ended up having to eat. That was my meal. So, it's just insane. And then I ended up having, like, we went to bed with this guy, but it was, like, not, it's like, oh, it's cool, he's just my friend. And I was like, I don't want to sleep in a bed with another guy. Like, I was like, come on. And it was just being lame at the end. But it was nice. We had, like, a really loving relationship. Like, it was kind of nice, like, getting to, like, you know, make out with Kristen Stewart. Yeah. All right, that's the story. Okay.